Hello everyone, welcome to a new video. Today, I will be comparing the prices of the Lidl in Spain versus Lidl's in Germany. And in case you're wondering how exactly did I do this little experiment, well, I basically went to Lidl's in Spain and also in Germany and wrote down the prices for different products. Also very important, I always took the cheapest option available, which in some cases this was the exact same product in both countries, but in others it was not the exact same one, because as you might know, Lidl offers several products which are common across countries, but then of course each country or maybe a specific region has different products that maybe the people living in that country buy more than in others. But what is the aim of this small study? Well, it is to see in which of these two countries it is cheaper to buy food, which percentage difference there is between these two countries, and also we'll be going product by product and seeing which are the differences in prices. Particularly because I think that the common conception is that prices in Germany are more expensive than in Spain. But actually, when I moved here, I realized that prices were also very cheap. The thing is, are they cheaper than in Spain? Well, with that said, and after I remind you that if you enjoyed the video, it would help me out massively, if you could give it a like, let's go and find it out. In total, I checked the prices for 25 different products that I think that they are very common and very commonly used, so that they are a bit more, you know, representative, hopefully, because then in the end, of course, each one of us has its preferences and maybe we buy more of one thing or the other. And also very important, I displayed all the prices based on the price per kilogram or per liter when it was, you know, liquid things. The first products are bananas, for which in Germany these are 35.97% cheaper than in Spain. Again though, I want to emphasize that these are the prices that I found when I did or when I went to the respective supermarkets, and especially when talking about fruits and vegetables, they are very seasonal. The prices also fluctuate depending on the seasons and how much offer and demand there is. So also note that of course these prices fluctuate and they are not 100% accurate of what maybe happens throughout the whole year. On bananas, for instance, I have seen them as cheap as 50 cents per kilogram or 1 euro per kilogram, of course, depending, I guess, on the offer that there is globally and the demand and so on. But moving next, we have potatoes, which are 46.32% cheaper in Germany than in Spain. Then we have the cheap version of Nutella, which is 4.28% cheaper in Germany. Then the iceberg lettuce has the exact same price in both countries. Apples are 29.53% more expensive in Germany. The toast bread is also 19.64% more expensive in Germany. Same for milk chocolate, which is 7.69% more expensive. The Captain Rondo cookies are 21.52% also more expensive in Germany. Pasta is 31.51% also more expensive, rice is 21.52% more expensive, fried tomato sauce is 6.02% more expensive also in Germany, chopped pork meat is 4.18% more expensive, chicken breasts are 6% also more expensive in Germany, milk is 19.3% more expensive, cooking cream is 54.04% more expensive in Germany, powdered cocoa that you use, you know, to mix with the milk is 1.7% more expensive in Germany. Then cereals are 18.21% cheaper in Germany. Sugar is 5.33% more expensive. Flour is 9.3% cheaper in Germany. Eggs are 16.28% more expensive in Germany. And please note that I only counted the dozen of eggs, not for each kilogram. Then we have olive oil, which is 113.21% more expensive in Germany, which again is understandable because olive oil comes either from, you know, Italy, maybe France, but Spain it's very typical. So it wouldn't make much sense that it's cheaper to buy it in Germany. And also I think that traditional wise in Germany people don't use as much olive oil as in Spain. Then the sunflower oil has the exact same price. The Gouda cheese is 8.09% cheaper in Germany. The Emmental cheese is 14.02% cheaper also. And the margarine is 39.62% cheaper in Germany too. So after describing the 25 products that I selected and that I just mentioned now, and again, if you want to check more in depth the specific price difference, then just feel free to pause the video. We basically have that out of all these products, we have 15 of these are cheaper to buy in Spain, 9 of these are cheaper to buy in Germany, and then 2 are half the exact same price in both countries. Just looking at this, we can already tell that it is cheaper to buy food in Spain than in Germany. But how much cheaper is it? Well, doing the average based on the percentage difference, we have that buying food in Germany is on average, and again, just for the selected products, 7.27% more expensive than in Spain. But here comes a very relevant point, and that personally it helps me save a lot of money, and on this I must say that Germany has a bit of an advantage versus Spain, which is that in Lidl, when products are about to expire on that same day, or I think maybe on the following 2 days, they put them at 50 or 30% discount. In the case of Germany, they put them at 50% discount. But in the case of Spain, this is only at 30%. It is not a massive difference, and usually you are still getting a good deal. But what I personally do is that I usually, when I see, for instance, meat that is expiring at 50%, I buy, you know, maybe 8 packs or something, I cut them, I put them in the freezer, and then I have enough meat for the next, I don't know, 4 or 5 months, whichever time span. And again, I can do the same in Spain, but it's just that the discount that I'm getting for that product, it's not 50%, but 30%. Going back to the average percentage difference of 7.27% more expensive in Germany than in Spain, as I already mentioned, very important, this is just based on the 25 items that I selected, which again, it might not be representative of what you buy or what you would buy. Then also we have that I check them in a specific time frame, which these prices again fluctuate. And we also have, for instance, that olive oil, we saw that it was 100 and something, like more than double the price buying it in Germany than in Spain. But of course, you don't buy the same amount or the same quantity of each of these products. So the fact that the olive oil is much more expensive, since you use less of it, it is likely to have much less of an impact on your shopping chart in general than if it were to be, for instance, the flour, pasta, or rice that maybe you buy much more of this. At the end of the day, I hope that this analysis is useful for you and that you kind of like get an overview, but please note that it is highly subjective because we all buy different things, although maybe there are some in common, and the exact impact on your shopping chart will depend on the exact items that you end up buying. But wait, because that's not the end of the video, as I would like to add now a very relevant point. As we have seen, prices in Germany are on average 7.27% higher for food than in Spain. But we also need to consider that salaries in Germany are higher than in Spain, which means that also people have more money that they can spend on food. More concretely, while the average salary in 2019 for Spain was of 2,295 euros gross per month, that of Germany was of 3,994 euros gross. This represents a difference of 74.03%, which is massive. True, in Germany the taxes are higher, so if we were to compare the net salaries, maybe the difference would not be 74%, but maybe let's say 50%. But still, 50% is more than the difference of 7.27% that there is in the prices of food. So in light of this, we can reach basically two different conclusions. Either we say that food in Spain is very expensive, or that food in Germany is very cheap, of course when comparing both countries. With that said though, I hope that you enjoyed this video. What are your thoughts on the comparison? Which were the things that surprised you the most? Please let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, then don't forget to leave it a like, subscribe to the channel if you're not yet subscribed, and as always, see you next time.